Multiplier being asked to get early position. Big Ben from the far outside crossing over. Manitoulin is right there, third. Minnesota and Oscar nominated. They come by us for the first time now. Multiplier, Joao Osorio to take the lead and show the way. There's one lap to go.
Horse, very, very long stride and very good mover. I always thought the longer would be the better for him. And he showed me that this year, the first time when I rode him at the Fairgrounds, he ran minus 16 and he was able to run down a horse named Dot Matrix, also trained by Brad Cox and with a few stakes on him. He's a nice horse, New York bred. So when he ran him down, and I just felt like with more distance, he would have beat him even easier. So I always thought, you know, that's the race we should circle and go for it. And Brad did a great job bringing him to the race today. In excellent shape and very good form, and the horse was able to deliver a big day.
It was a big win for him because he's, the horse always seemed like he's knocking it on the door at some of these races but hadn't really quite busted through.
Yeah, he is, but you know, he's also a great stakes winner too. He won on Derby Day, the American Turf, you know, a few years back with Mike on his back, and he ran a big race that day and beat some of the top horses in the country that day. So I always thought he could have do it, but sometimes he's been like, did be disappointed us some of his performance because we always felt like he has more into him. But today was a very solid field with some very nice horses, some grade one winner also, and great stakes horses, and he was able to beat them fairly and squarely.
Big Day had two stakes wins, two stakes seconds. I'm probably missing something.
Yeah, the staking second is no good. I was pretty upset about the Valadonna one. I felt she would run a winning race and a great trip, and I was not able to hold off the horse of Mr. Baltas. But I thought she ran a winning race and she was not able to hold on. And it was her first time actually on the turf, and I'm very proud of her. And I think that was great for Mark to try definitely on this race. I think he did a good job and almost pulled it off. And that's the one I feel like, that's the one escaped from us today. But no, a bunch of wins, couple of seconds, stakes, what a great day, but you always want more.
You know, the horse has been training incredibly well. He's been on his game. I mean, if you look at the rags of the thoroughgraphs, he's been steady and better every single time. So we knew he was sitting on a big race. Some horses over this track find a couple of extra points, and some horses lose a couple of points, and he seemed to be one that found a couple today, which he needed against the likes of the field they had here.
And are you looking at the Breeders' Cup with it? What might be next?
Well, you know, we kind of have an embarrassment of riches at the moment. We have Carrick, who just won the Secretariat, who's probably going to go in the Joe Hirsch, which is a win and you're in for the Breeders' Cup. We'll at least have some conversation about putting one in the Turf and one in the Classic. I haven't been here. I think it's been 25 years, and I barely remembered it. But this is, if you love turf racing, and our group does, as you can probably tell, this is a wonderful place. I can't wait to come back here.
Did you feel pretty good about his, you know, coming into this race? So you had the whole maker arsenal there. And
yeah. I felt good until the gates opened, and we thought we'd be sitting third very easily, and we were suddenly sitting at the back of the pack. But Florent was very patient, closed up ground on the backside, and then he made a key. If you watch the replay, he makes a key move in the first third of the stretch where he goes inside a horse instead of getting stopped and going outside. And this horse doesn't like to get stopped, so it might not have worked. That hole could have closed, but it didn't, and here we are.